April 8th, 1994. The body of Nirvana's frontman and rock and roll idol Kurt Cobain was found in his house in Seattle. A 27-year-old musician who was at the peak of his career had committed suicide by shooting himself in the head. For all Nirvana fans and music enthusiasts, the question remains, why did Kurt commit suicide? In this episode, we're going to carefully collect pieces of that puzzle and show you why and how it happened. In the early 1970s, Kurt was growing up as a happy kid in a working-class family, where he and his younger sister were at the center of everyone's attention. It was all going well for Kurt until his parents divorced. When his mother left their family home to pursue a new life, Kurt felt heartbroken and insecure. His parents' divorce had a dramatic impact on Kurt's character. From an excitable child, he turned quiet and indifferent. Eventually, his father married another woman who already had children from the previous marriage. Kurt suddenly became part of a much bigger family, where he was struggling to find his place. He believed that both his mother and father had betrayed him, and his quietness was rapidly transforming into hatred and aggression. Kurt dropped out of school, left his home, lived under a bridge, and started doing drugs. By ninth grade, he had already been smoking pot daily. It was his way of dealing with life's problems. He would learn from his family about other ways of solving life problems. Two of his uncles committed suicide, one in 1979 and the other in 1984. Suicidal tendencies in Cobain's family affected Kurt. One of his friends remembers Kurt talking about suicide all the time. Kurt was the shape of suicide. He looked like suicide, he walked like suicide. Hatred for his parents, drugs, suicidal thoughts, that sounds like a recipe for disaster. Yet Kurt seemed to have found himself in art and music. His hatred, loneliness, and pain had taken an artistic form. It was called Nirvana. Formed in 1987, the grunge band Nirvana quickly gained the masses' attention in the United States and Europe. By the 1990s, they had become the hottest band on earth. If Smells Like Teen Spirit was the anthem of the new generation, then Kurt Cobain was its voice, heart, and soul. Nirvana's fame and success didn't change Kurt, though. Same old clothes, same old lifestyle, and unfortunately, same old habits. In fact, his drug use was getting worse, much worse. After Kurt had started making some serious money from music, heroin became part of his existence. When Kurt got married to Courtney Love in February of 1992, there was a ray of hope that he could get his addiction under control. He finally found his soulmate, perhaps the only person who could fully understand him. But their relationship quickly took a more destructive bend. It was now Kurt and Courtney doing heroin together. Even their daughter's birth didn't stop the young couple, and they kept operating on drugs. Okay. Kurt hated his parents, saw relatives commit suicide, and operated on drugs. But why would he commit suicide? Well, on top of all those issues, Kurt faced a few more. Nirvana was becoming a dysfunctional band. Kurt didn't want to go on tour with Nirvana, as he couldn't imagine how he'd survive without his drugs. Here in the US, he had drug dealers lined up for him, but who would get him the dose once he's abroad? However, Kurt couldn't just say, "I'm not going on a tour." He already had contractual obligations with the record label. So Kurt was planning to avoid the upcoming world tour at all costs. Meanwhile, Nirvana was losing popularity as their iconic Nevermind album finally fell off the Billboard charts in mid-1993, after being on for just under 2 years. His relationship with Courtney was deteriorating. As described in Kurt's biography, Heavier Than Heaven by Charles Cross, his relationship with Courtney started falling apart because of the drug abuse. They'd been married for just 2 years, yet Kurt had already made numerous suicide attempts and overdoses. Even though they were both into drugs, Courtney was doing much better than Kurt. While he didn't want to lose Courtney and their daughter Frances, it was becoming apparent even for Kurt that this would be a very likely outcome. Rehab didn't work out. Even though Courtney finally persuaded Kurt to go through rehab, it didn't work for him. It almost feels like he gave up. He simply jumped the fence and ran away from the Exodus Rehab Center in LA, bought an airline ticket, and flew back to Seattle. So how did Kurt Cobain die? Well, from the rehab center in LA, he went straight to the airport and bought a first-class ticket to Seattle. Undoubtedly, he already had everything planned out. Upon his arrival to Seattle, he bought the bullets for his Remington Model 11 and, of course, heroin. A lot of heroin. Over the next few days, there were scattered sightings of Kurt. Courtney was desperately looking for him and even hired a private detective to help find her husband, but somehow Kurt managed to get away. On April 5, 1994, he returned to his house early in the morning, went to the greenhouse, located right about the garage, drank a can of his favorite beer, injected a large dose of heroin, and finally shot himself in the head with the rifle. Kurt's body was found 3 days later. There's not much more to add except that after Kurt's suicide, there were many murder conspiracy theories. One of them suggested that Courtney hired a killer to get rid of her junky husband, but we're not going to go there. As far as the death of Kurt Donald Cobain, this is how it was. Alright, if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you won't miss new episodes.